If this video is useful to you, please subscribe and click the bell icon, select all to get all my new video notifications.
So hi friends, in today's class I am going to explain about triangles. This is very important topic, triangles. So in all competitive exam or a school student, this is very important concept. So about this triangle I am going to explain today. If you are new for my channel, please click the subscribe button and select all, okay, click the bell button and select all to get all my new video notification. Please subscribe friends. Okay, now triangles. Tri means three here. Okay, angles. Say combination of three angles. Now here triangles are basically classified into two types. That is based on sides, based on angles. So here triangles are classified into two types, that is based on sides and based on angles here. Now based on sides, these again classified into three types. Okay, based on sides classified into three types. Again based on angles also classified into three types. Now see here, first one, equilateral triangle. Next one, scalene triangle. Okay, equilateral triangle and scalene triangle. And third one, isosceles triangle. These are based on sides. Now here based on angles, here acute angle triangle, and here right angle triangle, next one obtuse angle triangle. So acute angle triangle, we know that less than 0 to 90 degrees, the angles are 0 to 90 degrees. Right angle means one of the angle is 90 degrees. Obtuse angle is nothing but one of the angle is greater than 90. So that means 90 less than theta less than 180. So one of the angle here, one of the angle. So here all the angles below 90, 0 to 90. Here one of the angle is 90 degrees. So see here, this is right angle triangle and this is obtuse angle triangle. Here this is 50. Okay, 70 70 40. So all the angles are less than 90. All the angles are less than 90. So these type of triangles are called acute angle triangle. So see here, this is right angle triangle and this is obtuse angle triangle. Now equilateral triangle. So equilateral triangle is nothing but all the sides are equal. All the sides are equal. Scalene triangle nothing but all the sides are unequal. Isosceles triangle is nothing but two sides are equal, so third side is unequal. So these are types of triangles: equilateral, scalene, isosceles, acute angles triangle and right angle triangle, and obtuse angle triangle, based on angles and based on sides. They will ask the questions like this. They will give three sides, whether these sides can form triangle or not. Like this they will ask, 3, 5, 7, 10, 8, 15, whether these sides can form triangles or not. How we can find out whether the given sides can form a triangle or not? Now see here, very important points. These are very important conditions. You see here, This is the triangle A, B and C. A, B, C are three triangles, three vertices. A, B and C are three sides. Now, very important thing here. If whether the given sides can form a triangle or not, these conditions should follow. Sum of the two sides, AB plus AC, AB plus AC, that should be greater than third side, BC. AB plus AC, that should be greater than BC. Next one. AB plus AC is greater than BC. Next one, AB plus BC. AB plus BC is greater than AC. Or BC plus AC is greater than AB. This should follow. If these conditions follow, then that given sides can form a triangle. This is sum property, or otherwise difference of two sides, that means AB minus AC is less than BC, or AB minus BC is less than AC, or BC minus AC is less than AB. So that means in first case, sum of the two sides is greater than the third side, and second one, okay, here difference between the two sides, that should be less than the third side, then only that given sides can form a triangle. This is very very important thing. This is based on the side condition, if they will ask. Okay, so now see here, ABC is a triangle, sides are PQR, here R is largest side. Now, R square is less than P square plus Q square, then it is acute angle triangle. Next, R square equal to P square plus Q square, then it is said to be right angle triangle. Next, R square is greater than P square plus Q square, then it is said to be obtuse angle triangle. This is very important thing. In previous case, based on sides, here we have considered three sides. R is the largest side. If R square is less than P square plus Q square, then that's said to be acute angle triangle. If R square is equal to P square plus Q square, then it is said to be right angle triangle. Then R square is greater than P square plus Q square, then it is said to be obtuse angle triangle. This is very important formulas based on triangles. Now see here, first one, equilateral triangle, or it is called Samabahu Tribhujam. Equilateral triangle or Samabahu Tribhujam. Samabahu Tribhujam, nothing but it's an equilateral triangle. All three sides are equal and all angles are equal here. Here H is called height here. Now, all three sides are equal. All three sides are equal here. In equilateral triangle, all three sides are equal here. Here H is height. Okay, now here we should find out area, next perimeter, next height. These three formulas are very important. Okay, area, perimeter and height. We know that all three sides are equal, A. Okay, then its perimeter becomes A plus A, that equal to 3A. A plus A equal to 3A. Now, how we should find out this H value, height. Here, this is height, H, and area. So, how to find area. Area is root 3 a square by 4 and side is root 3 a by 2. These are very important formulas. Area is a root 3 a square by 4, perimeter is 3a, height is root 3 a by 2 for equilateral triangle. Isosceles triangle, it is called Samadvibhaja Tribhujam. Samadvibhaja Tribhujam, isosceles nothing but two sides are equal, one side is unequal. So AA, two sides are equal here, one is unequal. Now this is height, splits into two, okay, this third side into two equal parts here, B becomes B by 2 and B by 2 here. Now 2, so isosceles triangle is nothing but two sides are equal. Two sides are equal here. Now area, first one, second one height, and third one perimeter. These are very important points here. Area, height, and perimeter. Area of this isosceles triangle is, area of this isosceles triangle is b by 4 under root 4a square minus b square. Height of this right isosceles triangle is 1 by 2 4a square minus b square, and perimeter of this angle isosceles triangle is a plus b, that is 2a plus b. This is very important thing here. For every triangle we have deriving three formulas: area, height, and perimeter. Area, height, and perimeter. B by 4 under root 4a square minus b square. 1 by 2 under root 4a square minus b square. Perimeter is 2a plus b. Now scalene triangle, it is called Vishamabahu Tribhujam. Here in scalene triangle all three sides are unequal to each other. A and B and C here. Now here three sides are unequal. Three sides are unequal to each other here. Now area. Here area, we should derive a new formula, that is Heron's formula. Heron's formula. Area, for area, Heron's formula, that equal to under root S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. Here S equal to A plus B plus C by 2, and perimeter equal to A plus B plus C. Very important two formulas. In previous cases we have three formulas. Here in this case only two formulas, that is Heron's formula, S into S minus A, S minus B, S minus C under root S equal to A plus B plus C by 2. This is very important formula. You can use this formula for any triangle. Lamba Kona Tribhujam, right angle triangle, Lamba Kona Tribhujam. Here A, B, C are three vertices. Okay, A, B, B, C, C, A are three sides. One of the angle, that is 90 degrees. Now what is the area? If one of the angle is 90 degrees, okay, then it is said to be right angle triangle. Now see here, area. Area of this right angle triangle is half into B into H here. Okay, here base, this is H, height, and this is hypotenuse. Now area, perimeter equal to, so here you can take P, H plus P plus B, and you can write here P square equal to, this is Pythagoras formula, okay, Pythagoras formula for right angle triangle, P square is equal H square plus B square, or P is equal under root H square plus B square. These are very important formulas but right angle triangle. Area is half into b into x, perimeter x plus b plus b, and p square equal to x square plus b square, or p equal to under root x square plus b square. Now isosceles right angle triangle, then it is called lamba kona samadvibahu tribhujam. Lamba kona samadvibahu tribhujam. Now see here, in isosceles right angle triangle, two sides are equal here, then area you can write half a square, that means b into h, that becomes half a square, perimeter 2a plus p here. Next you can write, if you apply the Pythagorean formula, p square equal to a square plus a square, p square is equal to 2a square, p equal to root 2a. Very, very important formulas. Area of a square, perimeter 2a plus p, here p equal to under root 2a. Circumcircle and incircle, this is equilateral triangles. Equilateral triangle. Here this is called circumcircle and this is called incircle. Now circumcircle, area equal to pi a square by 3 here, and radius capital R equal to a by root 3. This is very important. Next here, in circle, area equal to pi a square by 12, small r radius equal to a by 2 root 3. Very important formulas. Pi a square by 3, a by root 3 here, pi a square by 12, r equal to a by 2 root 3. These are very important formulas. Compulsory one question you will get. This is the triangle ABC. If you join the midpoint of this triangle DEF, if you join the midpoint of this triangle, now area of D triangle DEF equal to 1 by 4 area of triangle ABC. This is very important. Okay, by joining the midpoint of a triangle, you are going to form a new triangle, that is DEF. Area of this triangle DEF equal to 1 by 4 of area of triangle ABC. This is a very, very important topic, triangle. Okay, watch this video 2 or 3 times, then you will get full concept of triangles. Okay, if you like this video, please subscribe my channel, share this video. Okay, thank you friend.